For his time, he was certainly what we would consider a visionary today.
I think Lincoln was a visionary. I think all leaders have to be visionaries to see beyond their own time, beyond their own place.
America defines itself by its view of Lincoln. Well, I think in his interpretation of the Declaration of Independence and the United States Constitution, founding documents of the United States, he interpreted those as envisioning a united nation. And that was one of the things behind his determination to keep the country united during the Civil War. He believed very strongly in the Union, and I'd say that interpretation came from his reading of those founding documents.
One of the amazing things to me about Lincoln is that he grew up here in southern Indiana in a place that was a wilderness without really much in the way of education and opportunity. That side of his story is well known, I think, particularly down here in southern Indiana. But Lincoln's vision went so far beyond that in what he saw as America. He was interested in transportation improvements, for example, canals and railroads. He was interested in building cities and factories and all the sorts of things that made America what it came to be. He saw that kind of America.
His views on many of the key issues of the day, slavery, race, just his concept of what the United States as a nation should be, were his ideas on those subjects tended to be far ahead of what many other people were thinking at the time.
The other place, of course, where Lincoln's a visionary is as leader of the Civil War. That story is fairly well known, but it bears retelling again and again, I think, because there's no doubt but that this was the very, very most difficult time in all of American history when he assumed the office of the presidency in the spring of 1861. That was as bad as it's ever gotten. And how this man from southern Indiana provided the kind of vision, the kind of leadership that he did, is one of the great mysteries in American history. But we know he did it. We know he did it in so many, many different ways in those years from 1861 until 1865.
His life has taken on almost mythical proportions over time. Certainly the circumstances during which he lived, what was happening to the country at the time, his leadership during that time period, and then his tragic death, in a sense becoming the last casualty of the war that had threatened to tear the country apart. All of those things, I think, have fixed Lincoln indelibly in our collective consciousness.
Well, I think we've learned so many things from Lincoln that is relevant today. I like, for example, the line from his second inaugural address, "With malice toward none, with charity toward all." Said at a time when the Civil War was still not over, a time when brother literally was killing brother, when the hatred between North and South was so large, when Lincoln, as a victorious or soon-to-be victorious president, could have been in their face, demanding executions of Southern leaders, demanding all kinds of extraordinary measures against a defeated nation, instead, with malice toward none, with charity toward all. That takes immense vision, immense leadership, and really a heart that is, I think, very, very much to be admired and emulated today.
I think having someone like Lincoln who was able to see the bigger picture in a way, he was able to lead the country through that time when those tensions were so strong.
Thank you.